Phil Moore. He was a pianist, he was an arranger, a composer, and an orchestrator. He was also Lena Horne's accompanist. He also did a lot of work for many singers. But he could do it for everything. He was writing for MGM, MGM movies. I came here with Lunsford. I met him the first week I came here. He came out to bring an arrangement for the Jimmy Lunsford Band to rehearse. And he wanted to sell it to them, which he did. And I was amazed at this orchestration, this arrangement, and this composition. And right away, I wanted to meet this man and be a friend of his. And he liked me, too, because after all, I had numbers on record already. He knew that I could write. We became very good friends. And when I left the Lunsford Band, I came out here and I worked on every record that he practically made with Lena Horne, in the movies with Lena Horne, doing stuff with Lenny Hayden and her recordings. Phil also was recording for the same guy that I later recorded for, Albert Marks, on Discovery Records. He made many, many sides on Discovery Records that featured, some featured Calvin Jackson, the great pianist. These would be with large orchestras, 35 pieces, 40 pieces. It would be a jazz orchestra or whatever. He did the trombone concerto that was written by Nathaniel Shilkret. He was a big man out here at MGM, and Phil did so much work out at MGM. It was Phil Moore who did the arrangements. See, Duke Ellington, when they were making Cabin in the Sky, I believe, Cabin in the Sky, Duke had to leave. He couldn't finish up the picture. So at that time, Barney Bigard had left Duke. Rex Stewart had left Duke. So you got two great soloists here that were in the Duke Ellington Orchestra. And Phil Moore is the only man I know beside Billy Strayhorn that could write just like Duke Ellington when he wanted to, if he had to. He did. He finished the arrangements and the pieces, and the people thought it was Duke Ellington's band. And this was a band he picked up around town. I was in the band. Lee Young, Lester's brother, was the drummer. Red Callender was on bass. So Phil Moore was amazing. He's the guy that wrote Shoo Shoo Baby, by the way, which was a huge pop hit. Went to the top of the hit parade. I played with this group, by the way. It's called Phil Moore and One More. I was the one more. I was the trumpet player. He wanted me to go to New York with him to play at the Cafe Society, where he played for many weeks. And he later made his home in New York for a long time. He had his apartment in the Carnegie Hall building. That's where his apartment was and where it should be, because he's truly one of the great musicians of our time. He turned me on to things that I had never been turned on. I'd go over to his home, we'd listen to Stravinsky's Petrushka, we'd listen to The Firebird, we'd listen to Kachaturin, I'd listen to Kovalevsky, Glier, Villalobo, you know, all kinds of modern composers and things. So Phil is one of my truly mentors.